Well, actually, I think that what we're simply doing is going and retesting what had happened. Investors experienced a 7% decline in the S&P 500. We saw the growth sector decline twice as much as the value sector. And now we've been bouncing off of that low. But we are just going through a technical reflex rally. I don't think we can say that the correction is finally over. Yes, it seems as if buy the dip mentality is still in place. We did have a 3-trading-day sell-off within the S&P, bringing it to exactly the definition of a pullback, which is a 7% decline. Yet it happened much quicker than pullbacks traditionally take, and it looks as if we're going to be getting back to break even more rapidly than normal, possibly because nothing has really changed as compared with what was pushing the market higher, lower rates, expectation for some sort of a coronavirus vaccine by the beginning of next year. Yet the extremes in valuations, the difference between growth and value, I think are sounding alarm bells, but that's not enough to trigger a meaningful sell-off in the market. I think that Oracle really has been sort of a secondary player to Microsoft and other of these systems software companies for quite some time, and they want to get back into the game, and I think that they're doing so with TikTok. We still have a sell recommendation on the Oracle shares. Our belief is you're better positioned with Microsoft and some of the other sector leaders. I would think that a major trigger could be a triple play in that you have the Democrats gain control of the White House, the Senate, and the House of Representatives. In that case, because the stated policy by a Biden administration would be to increase the taxes on capital gains and dividends, likely more than doubling where they are today. So I think investors would probably say, you know what, I'll take my tax bite while I know it's at 21%, rather than risk waiting to take the tax bite in 2021 at a rate that's as high as 43%+. So I believe that a Democratic sweep could end up triggering some tax selling in November. I think the Federal Reserve would like to have some sort of assistance. They'd like to see the cavalry come over the hill. By that I mean that they would like to see Congress pass some sort of a stimulus plan, because monetary policy alone won't do it. That we're going to need fiscal policy as well. But leading up to the elections, I don't think the Democrats want to give the Republicans any reason to crow. And as a result, probably nothing will be done until after the election. But I think the Federal Reserve will be indicating that it needs to see Congress act in a meaningful way, while at the same time reminding investors that low for longer emphasizes longer, and that it could end up being a couple of years, not just a couple of quarters.